very well so far. Meantime, West Virginia has run the ball well with Shane Alston and Tavon Austin, and it is going to be West Virginia football on a cold day in Ames, where it feels like about 17 degrees with that wind going from left to right. And this is Stedman Bailey on the kickoff return out to the 31-yard line. Dave Lamont, Kelly Stauffer, and our ESPN crew here, very, very happy to be with you in Ames, Iowa, and around the country as we show you our Pacific Life game summary.
And Geno really hasn't gotten off in the pass game yet. He's made pretty good decisions, been frustrated a little bit, a couple of throws down the field, but it's been very controlled. But at the end of the day, he's getting it done with his running backs. And then Sam Richardson, the 73 yards rushing, typically were drive extenders. And then he found ways to finish drives as well.
So on the ground goes West Virginia, and here is Austin, and he just takes it out of bounds rather than take the hit from Jacquez Washington. That's a good gain, though, on first down. It'll be a pickup of about six, second and four coming up.
And the diversity in West Virginia's run game in the first half was, I think, the issue for Iowa State. They have the speed of Austin, and then Alston comes in and just is a battering ram between the tackles.
Austin splits out. There he is in the second of those three receivers to the left. And Geno Smith with a quick out. That's going to be a first down for West Virginia. Catch made by J.D. Woods. He had a very productive first half for the Mountaineers.
Yeah, that's his fifth catch. And Stedman Bailey had four catches, only four catches in the first half. But remember that with Austin in the backfield a lot, Iowa State can roll coverage to Bailey, so Woods should have some opportunities.
Geno Smith has hit his last seven passes. You see our weather conditions right here. That's a steady wind, too, today, and it gusts higher. And in traffic, and Smith, that was a laser shot. And a catch made there by Bailey. Tackle made by Kenneth Lynn. And again, the Iowa State secondary functioning without a key player. Strong safety Darrell Gibbons not playing today.
Yeah, Sage Schaefer had a big half, had 11 tackles in the first half, filling in for Givens, being an extra run defender in the box against that newly found West Virginia run game.
Second down and a couple. You see West Virginia 10-1 under Dana Holgorsen, taking the lead into the dressing room, and there is one of the few ineffective runs for Sean Alston as A.J. Klein, 47, in there on the stop.
Well, Dave, you and I were just talking about it. A.J. Klein needs to show up in the second half against this West Virginia's newfound desire to run the football, especially between the tackles. A.J. Klein needs to get off here in the second half.
Mountaineers 2 out of 5 on third down.
Really tough matchup for Iowa State right there with Austin in the slot.
There he goes. And they send him out and send Alston up the middle for the West Virginia first down. But he draws your eyes.
Absolutely.
We're going to say the same thing. Alston draws your eyes away, and it's just a simple dive play from there.
Yeah, that's one of the guys that Iowa State has to account for, and you're right. In the end, it's a simple dive play, but the defense is wondering why number one Alston is going in motion.
Geno Smith out in the open, gets it completed to Connor Arlia, and there you see Jacquez Washington, number 10, kept that play from doing anything. As a matter of fact, they're going to lose a couple of yards, second down and a dozen.
Yeah, great reaction out of the secondary by Washington on that screen play, and Arlia is not exactly the guy that you're going to build touches for, but they wanted to change it up, but great reaction by Washington right there.
There's the veteran defensive coordinator Wally Burnham for the Cyclones.
Old school.
Long throw by Smith. Great coverage that time by Kenneth Lynn. You just now see that Stedman Bailey caught the pass. Lynn got there so quickly you couldn't even see who it was. That far, that's Jeremy Reeves, number 5, not 6. Kenneth Lynn on the coverage. It's going to be gain of 7, third down and about 5 on the opening drive of this third quarter.
And Bailey on the out route is that true number one prototypical receiver that can get things done vertically. They need to find number 3 more in this second half.
6 catches, 76 yards for Bailey and a touchdown. Underneath they go. This is Arlia, and he'll have the first down. He got hit, but he got the first down. And there's A.J. Klein again, and also Schaefer with another tackle, number 16.
You can see Arlia coming underneath right there. And very good recognition by Geno Smith early in the progression. That was a good outlet receiver against a soft zone coverage by Iowa State.
11 in a row for Geno. Now he'll hand off to Austin on the short side of the field. He does not get very much. It'll be second and long coming up. They didn't give him a lot of room to work with in the first place, and there's Klein again.
Absolutely. I think Klein got the message at halftime that he needs to be more active. This isn't a West Virginia team that wants to throw the football all over the parking lot. They had a run mentality in the first half, and A.J. Klein needs to be that counter for Iowa State's defense.
He'll try to keep the short side of the field. A lot of collisions there around the 29-yard line. He stays in bounds. Clock will keep rolling in the third quarter. Gain of 5.
And you can see Alston's main skill set is he's a pile mover. And that's something that this offense has lacked. The guy that can run with a little bit of an attitude, even when it isn't blocked impeccably well on the line of scrimmage, make guys miss, but get yards after contact.
11th play of the drive against Wally Burnham's defense. Austin out of the backfield. There he goes. One-on-one with Klein. Made a miss, and he squirts loose for the first down. And I don't know whether Klein is hurt or frustrated. It looks like he's just frustrated with himself as he gets up quickly.
But you said it exactly right. You can see Austin coming out of the backfield. Geno sees the one-on-one with the linebacker. There isn't really many linebackers in the entire country that want to be one-on-one with Austin out of the backfield.
First down, West Virginia. They're not going to like playing Austin on Sundays either. Geno Smith looked deep down the field, flagged down behind the play. The pass caught at the 17-yard line by J.D. Woods, but...
Yeah, I think Jeff Braun, the right guard.
Number 57, 10-yard penalty, repeat first down.
And Braun really didn't need to do it, but you can see him right here at the end of the play. Geno was going to get this ball off. He understood the pressure. And right there, the up and under. And Geno is moving away from that pressure anyway, but it's instinctive for a guard to protect the quarterback, and I don't blame him one bit.
Well, yeah, you're a quarterback, that's why.
I love those guys up front.
First down and 20. And there's that little tap to Stedman Bailey. That's going to get inside the 30 down to the 28, maybe the 27-yard line. Still going to be a little bit of work here. They've got to get down to the Iowa State 13 for a first down, for second and long.
And a lot of offensive football is whether you can overcome a potential drive-killing play somewhere along the way. And we've already seen the holding penalty has been presented to West Virginia. Can they overcome it right here?
West Virginia with that brisk wind at their backs.
Should be a favorable matchup down here.
And they're going to run in that direction. And over to the 25-20. And there is Klein again, number 47, right in the face of Austin. Almost a penalty. Little bit of yapping going on now with Jeremiah George, number 52 for Iowa State.
I wonder if Klein can actually watch tape. You can see the look in his eyes. Much different attitude out of their leader on the defensive side in this second half. He's going to play at a different level here in the second half.
This is his last game in Ames, a senior from Kimberly, Wisconsin. Here he comes on third and a dozen on the blitz. Geno Smith in trouble. He got away and he sacked. Brought down by Cleon Lang. And Geno Smith, look on his face like, where did all of those people come from? It's fourth down and 13, and here comes the kicker, Tyler Bittenkirk.
Iowa State bringing all kinds of chaos, and that's what Wally Burnham likes to do. When an offense is driving the football, Iowa State will try to bring pressure to create that negative play. They've been successful so far in the second half.
First sack of the game for either team. Bittenkirk, 1 for 2. We almost had a third kick hit an upright. That one just tucked in. West Virginia now leads 20-14. Geno Smith sees the pressure, and it's just too much Cardinal and gold. At one time, Geno Smith was at the top of the Heisman list when West Virginia was 5-0. And they run into some trouble when they hit the Big 12 skid. His numbers are not terrible, Kelly, but he's no longer on the Heisman list.
You can see that percentage down, touchdowns down, and that's where the interceptions came. And he started kind of pressing, get frustrated. He wasn't getting plays down the field. He was being defended differently as well. People were dropping into coverage, but I think he's beginning to figure it out. He's being more patient. He's making much better decisions here in the last couple of games.
Made his last 12 passes, and a lot of folks around the NFL still have him at the top of their quarterback draft lists. Here is Jarvis West, 35, out to the 37-yard line. Great field position for the Cyclones. Let's check in with John Saunders. Entering the Columbus, Ohio airport now, welcoming you to All-Star Weekend in the NHL. That's not going to happen. Iowa State's first play of this half on offense, and they run a kind of a jet sweep look for a decent gain with Albert Gary, the redshirt junior from Ocala, not far from the University of Florida. That's a four-yard pickup, second and six.
And that's what Iowa State will do. They will bring the receiver in motion and Gary that particular time, but they run outside zone quarterback read. They try to get it to the edge to thin out that defense.
The redshirt freshman Richardson, he's taking off again. He's got a little bit of room, made a man miss, and gets into West Virginia territory at the 47-yard line before the tackle made by Shaq Petaway. That's a gain of 11. And Richardson is the leading rusher today for Iowa State with 84 yards.
Yeah, the most productive part of Iowa State's offense has been this young man's decision-making. And a lot of times as a young quarterback translates into use your feet well.
Yeah, he uses his arm well. Wide receiver wide open near the marker. And I'm not sure he got the first down. You see where the official is there. Quentin Bundridge, number 9 with a catch. Chestnut on the stop. It's a gain of 9. Second and short is next.
And the offensive coordinator, Courtney Messingham, we'll see if he makes it right here. Then he goes back. He had it at one time and went back. And do they give him forward progress? They don't.
And on second and short, that pass bounces in, so a surprise throw. And again, Bundridge. One thing with the wind, now Iowa State's going into the wind. We're just not seeing deep passes today.
You're right. It's more manageable stuff, and I think that's pretty wise unless you have a big play opportunity down the field. It's been more management stuff.
Straight ahead, and that's going to be a first down. You saw Josh Francis sell out, but Shaq Petaway able to... Number 36. That was actually Carl Joseph, number 8. Those 8 and 4s getting condensed. They look somewhat similar. It was Joseph who came in from the safety position and almost blew that play up. And it's a first down for the Cyclones. Longest pass for Iowa State today, 18 yards. This is Chantel Johnson, number 21, gets a couple, maybe only one. Terrence Garvin in there along with Shaq Rowell. At stake for West Virginia today, bowl eligibility. You saw that 5-5 record. They do have one more game to play in Morgantown next week against the bottom team of the Big 12, Kansas. But still, you want some momentum going into home.
You
want to end, obviously, the losing streak. Iowa State already bowl eligible.
Yeah, you would think they would win that last game, but... they've been saying it for 6 weeks.
Here's your deep pass down the field. In the end zone, it's a caught touchdown by Quentin Bundridge.
Iowa State has been running it really well, and then it's just a go route right over the top, and top of Bundridge gets on top of Chestnut, number 16. West Virginia has had incredible problems outside covering vertical routes, and that's a perfect example of it right there.
That's the longest touchdown pass of Richardson's career, 35 yards. He has 6 touchdown passes now, going back to when he took over early in the Kansas game last week. and into the wind. What a gorgeous throw this is by the redshirt freshman from Winter Park. Iowa State on top for the first time today. 7 career touchdown passes and no interceptions.
Not bad.
And he took over only a week ago.
Not bad at all.
So into the breeze. Look at that kick just hang there. And that's going to set up Tavon Austin. Makes one miss. Makes two miss. Looking for a block. Now he'll take the middle. And he's had enough. Let's. Tavon Austin needs a break. We'll take it with him.
Guys outside, that's a great way to isolate them on play action pass. Try to get that safety down in the box.
Now let's see how West Virginia reacts. This is a different formation than what we've seen. Geno Smith looking deep down the field. He goes down the field. Long throw knocked away at midfield. There you see Jeremy Reeves getting a hand in front of Stedman Bailey. Second down and 10. And that breaks 12 straight completions for Smith.
And Jeremy Reeves does a great job. It's Bailey is running the deep over route and then the catch-up speed right at the very end. Perfectly played by Jeremy Reeves.
Now again, this time West Virginia has the win and is at their backs as opposed to what you saw Richardson throw into the wind for the touchdown. Back to the ground. And not a lot there. That's Austin on the carry. Willie Scott, a redshirt junior from Orlando, in there to make the stop. Third down and about 8 coming up.
And how about how Iowa State is defending Tavon Austin as a running back? And Oklahoma couldn't do it, obviously, last week.
Well, they didn't know. To be fair to them, they didn't know it was coming.
And that's what I was going to say. The preparation that Iowa State has had to think about it certainly has made a difference here this afternoon.
Smith firing, incomplete. Trying to fit it into J.D. Woods. Cliff Stokes, a junior college transfer, was in coverage. And it's 4th down and 8. Here comes Tyler Bittenkirk and the Mountaineer punt team.
The luxury that Iowa State has when Tavon Austin isn't the second quick receiver out there, you can see the break on the ball by Stokes. Very well done. But they're rotating coverage as Iowa State to put a top over Bailey and keep a safety over the top of him. But they're playing very good defense the rest of the way, like you saw Stokes do right there.
Aaron Horn is by himself around the 26-yard line. Bittenkirk, here comes a big rush, and it's an end-over-end wobbler. Gives Horn a chance, 35. Ooh, man, he takes a hit. Ooh, 37-yard line, 5-yard return, 37-yard punt. The West Virginia Mountaineers say they have the ball, but the officials say it belongs to the Cyclones. Horn really got drilled. Glad to see that he's up. He's a and I don't blame him for being a little bit wobbly because he really got melted.
Yeah, right at the very end, his horn's going down right there.
Well, that's dead on helmet to helmet.
Wow, that was brutal.
No flag on that play. That's undoubtedly what may have led to Horn leaving the ball on the ground for a second. From the 36-yard line, good field position for Iowa State. West Virginia just now getting their defense out there.
And remember, West Virginia has been defensively challenged this year. And you can see right now, Iowa State has some confidence. They've found some things they like offensively.
On the ground, here's James White. White breaking a tackle and is dragged down finally by Terrence Garvin. Looks like he's going to be a yard shy, gain of 9, 2nd down and 1.
And Iowa State right now is saying this: if you're going to keep your safeties deep to cover your corners, it's a favorable run look for us. We're going to run the football.
And they're going to try again with White. This time he is swallowed up. Very close, but if you go by that official coming to your screen right now, they did not make it. It's going to be 3rd down and short, and really short.
Well, I think that was a bad spot, and spots obviously can be reviewed as well.
Nothing coming from anywhere, no whistles. They go to Woody. 1st down. The throwback fullback, Jeff Woody, didn't even, he turned his back right away. He put both hands over the football, turned the back, and got the first down.
Yeah, it's all about ball security and run downhill as fast as you can when Jeff Woody, number 32, comes in there. He's really kind of the short yardage goal line blocker that they throw him a bone and let him carry at that time.
And here's a reverse to Jarvis West, well covered by West Virginia. Darwin Cook made a ton of tackles from his safety position, number 25 for the Mountaineers, and then lost about a yard on that. But it'll be second down and 11 coming up for the Cyclones.
And Josh Francis did a really nice job. He was actually the edge defender where that reverse was coming to. He made it go back inside and then very well defended inside as well.
Fast moving third quarter. We're down to 2 minutes in this period. West Virginia led at halftime 17-14. Richardson has hurt West Virginia with his feet, lobs one to midfield. It is knocked loose, incomplete, closing very quickly. Nick Kwiatkowski, he saw that play coming. Richardson kind of hung that one up a little bit.
And once again, the quick pressure inside. You can see West Virginia rushing four, getting the quick pressure, and Josh Francis probably got held right there by Jacob Gannon. It wasn't called, but the quick pressure inside forces Richardson to throw off his back foot.
So James White shaking up on the play. He was the Cody Zeller and the Hoosiers. Then Wednesday, the Spartans and the Hurricanes. And also you're going to get to the Buckeyes and the Blue Devils. Wow, that's such a great challenge. Richardson held in the pocket. Is there going to be a flag for interference? Nothing coming from the officials. The intended receiver was Chris Young, broken up by Pat Miller.
Pat Miller does a great job of breaking on the ball. There's certainly contact. You can see the official looking directly at it. It wasn't egregious, and it didn't change the ability for the receiver to get through the football. I think that's great coverage by Pat Miller.
Well, I can tell you haven't played quarterback in a while. I'm just thinking if was you who threw that pass.
What did I just say?
I want that tape.
It's
marked.
Always pass interference.
I can't believe it. This is an NFL quarterback right here.
I
just defended
completely gone off my rocker.
Vanderkamp on a fake. Does he have the first down? He's right at the marker. The collision is there, and he appears to have the first down. Jordan Thompson hit him. The spot is a first down.
And this is something that is typically set up by looks they've seen earlier. And right there, if you see the right look, Vanderkamp has the green light. But he didn't have the first down until he lowers his shoulder. And I never thought I would say that about a punter. But right there, he gets physical and actually converts. That's tremendous.
He got hit. But the Cyclones keep it. What a play. And now they go to Woody to the 38-yard line, a gain of three. It'll be second down and seven.
But Dave, those are the type of decisions you make when you're playing. You can see Vanderkamp right there. It's like, what did I just do? It's one thing running it. It's another thing lowering your shoulder and converting. That was awesome.
So Richardson rolling, and he'll just lower his shoulder, and he's down to the 35-yard line. A short gain. Jarrett Barber on the stop. Iowa State trying to get a seventh win under Paul Rhodes for the second time. There's a program that for a while just winning seven seemed almost impossible. They had some close calls with Dan McCartney. They got to a situation where they almost won a division 1 year. 2005, couldn't do it. But Paul Rhodes has been successful here in Ames. Richardson, does he dump it off to Woody? No, he goes deep down the field into traffic, incomplete. Broken up by Darwin Cook. That was a scary throw. Chris Young, the intended receiver, and it's fourth down. Now, fourth and four. I think you got it. Punting here seems to me superfluous.
Yeah, I think you have to go for it right here. And I think if you're going to run a fake punt, you're certainly going to go for it. Even though it's fourth and the better part of 4 yards, I think going for it right here is the right decision by Paul Rhodes.
And Richardson has proven himself to be dangerous in these situations because if he gets an edge, he's been able to get first downs.
Yeah, West Virginia needs to contain the quarterback in the run game.
They bring pressure. Richardson throws, passes tipped, and incomplete. The umpire said it's incomplete. It wouldn't really have mattered if the pass had been caught anyway by Kwiatkowski. It is turnover on downs for the West Virginia defense.
That fake punt by Vanderkamp goes for naught, but I think that's the type of decision-making that goes into realizing that you have to pull out all stops when you're playing West Virginia. They're going to get more points before this game's out.
That is the sixth Vanderkamp fake in his career, by the way. So now, the fans here in Ames, and it's not a pretty day outside. Well, it's pretty in the clouds, but cold in here. These folks have stayed bundled up, cheering on their defense. This is Sean Alston. And that's the way he has run all afternoon for West Virginia. Stops the clock with 9 seconds to go after that first down. And Alston is now over 100 yards, 102 on the afternoon here in Iowa State. And that will be the end of our quarter. We've got a wonderful Big 12 game here. West Virginia trying to end a five-game losing streak and get to bowl eligibility. Iowa State's already got their 6 wins. This presentation of college football presented by K Jewelers will continue after this message and a word from our ABC stations.